Hey guys, how are you doing? In this episode, we are going to see some useful Apple Watch battery saving tips that will help you to get better battery backup. I'm using Apple Watch since Series 2 and I've been following these tips, and in this video I also like to give some suggestions or measures that you need to follow in order to get good battery health, at the same time good battery performance overall with your Apple Watch. I have suggested these tips to my friend circle and to my audience and found it very effective. Before starting with the tips, I need to mention one important thing, that if your Apple Watch is like 3 to 4 generations older, you can try these tips. If it is too older, like the battery health already reached around 70% or below, then these tips will not work. The very first tip that you can try is installing apps that are only necessary on your Apple Watch. Even though Apple Watch has separate storage that allows you to install applications that you already installed on your iPhone, it can automatically install and update the apps on both the iPhone and Apple Watch as well. So from your watch app, you need to take control of what applications that you're installing on your Apple Watch. That is very important, because each app will consume a certain amount of system resources and the battery resource as well on your Apple Watch, so that could cause unnecessary battery drain. So remove any apps right from the watch app, and that will help you to get good battery backup. The second one is similar to the iPhone. If you don't use the background app refresh feature, like if you're using it for jogging, running, and any specific third-party application that requires background app refresh, then you should keep it on. Otherwise, if there is no such apps you have installed that needs background app refresh, then you can turn it off entirely, or you can toggle those applications only to be on, and all other unnecessary applications utilizing the background app refresh feature can be turned off within your Apple Watch. This will definitely be helpful in order to get, maintain your Apple Watch battery backup, and you won't be experiencing fast Apple Watch battery drain problem repeatedly over the usage. And the next important feature that you need to take control is Siri and search. Within the settings, when you scroll down a bit, you can access the Siri section. So here you need to keep the Siri functions on only if you're using Siri on your Apple Watch. If you're using it for any shortcut or if you're using it for making calls, then it is recommended to keep it on. Otherwise, if you use your iPhone for most of the Siri related features, then toggle off the Siri features, because it does consume quite good amount of battery backup on your Apple Watch, just like on your iPhone. In the background, sometimes, even though the Siri is not consuming that much amount of battery, some WatchOS specific bugs can cause huge battery drain because of Siri related bugs. So if you're not using it Siri, you can keep it off. Otherwise, keep it on. So the fourth one is taking control of the notifications. This one, have no much toggles right inside the watch app settings, but whatever the settings that you have on your iPhone notifications preference automatically synced to your Apple Watch as well. So make sure to take control of the notifications permission given to each and every application on your iPhone, so that it won't unnecessarily wake up the display and process all those information continuously. The notifications that you receive on your iPhone will also be pushed to your Apple Watch. For older Apple Watch model, this will definitely be very useful, because notifications does take quite a strong amount of battery power. The next one is location services. This also needs to be taken control on your iPhone. Don't turn it off on your iPhone or on your Apple Watch without proper understanding, because Find My Network, if there is any theft or lost to your Apple Watch or iPhone, this location services feature is very important. So you should not turn it off within your Apple Watch. You can see that all the controls are managed from your iPhone. So whatever the apps that is installed here, make sure that app location services permission given only while using, or never if the app don't need any location services access. That can also consume quite strong amount of battery when the Apple Watch continuously uses the location services and related permissions. Even on new Apple Watch models, when the location services goes crazy, then the battery drain will be pretty faster. The next one is making sure the heart related features, the sensors, are properly configured. I don't recommend to turn this feature off, because the purpose of using Apple Watch is to receive alert on time when there are some complications or irregular heart rhythm. So just check whether the essential features are turned on. And normally I get 2 to 3 days backup for my Apple Watch Ultra when I use it also for few calls on mobile data when the iPhone is not nearby. Otherwise, I'll get a little bit extra than 3 days. If you use more for calls and messages, device cellular data feature, then obviously you will get reduced battery backup. That is absolutely normal. Whether it is Apple Watch Ultra or Apple Watch Series 7 or 8 or 9, it doesn't matter. Based on your usage, your battery consumption will be a bit higher. But normally we get 2 days for moderate usage conditions. The next important troubleshooting step that I like to suggest is, like, even after following these steps, if you are experiencing the battery drain, then within your Apple Watch, you need to perform all settings reset once. That will definitely be helpful in order to fix any settings related bugs causing the battery drain. The next one is make sure you have updated WatchOS to latest version, because each time Apple releases software related update, they do mention what the content of this update, not, you know, completely transparent, but WatchOS updates does help to fix any battery drain related bugs and problems. You can also search our channel about watch battery health. You know, simply by searching, you will find the video related to the tips that I have shared that I've been following for a long time to maintain my Apple Watch battery health. If you're worried about battery health instead of the battery drain, then that video will definitely be helpful to you. I'll leave a link to that in the description and in the first comment. You can check that out if you're worried about the battery health. So these are the tips that will definitely be helpful with the Apple Watch battery drain and battery health. At the same time, one more important thing I like to include is always use the genuine charger cable that came with the Apple Watch, or if it is damaged and it is not working, I would suggest not to compromise on the cost and consider getting the new Apple Watch charging cable from Apple showroom or from Apple website. The reason is third-party chargers that I have tried either heat up the Apple Watch too much, and that will definitely be a bad sign for Apple Watch battery health overall. And I got this kind of dock setup to not move the cable, or even if I want to move, that rubber dock setup on my work desk will prevent the cable ends from getting damaged frequently. I'll leave a link to that accessory for both Amazon US and Amazon India in the description and in the first comment. If you need such accessory to be purchased, you can check that out. And the original cable also fast charging supported. So my suggestion is to use original cable all the time to make sure that your Apple Watch battery health and overall battery is maintained very well for long-term usage. So do try these tips, and after 2 to 3 weeks of observation, feel free to share how the experience overall, whether these tips helped you to get good battery backup or not, in the comment section. Thank you. And for more tips and tricks, don't forget to subscribe. Have a wonderful day.